Name's new.
No, I'm the cook.
And last, I told you to leave my tools alone. We'll have you.
Big log on the fire. Gotta have the little bits too.
Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
Enough. This ends now.
Get out of here.
You are taking us somewhere warm.
Jezargo only has so much room to carry things.
We follow them.
To get lost.
Kahjit got me. Here, right here. Very well. Jezargo shall wait.
Thank you. it again. That was quite the trek. Come on, I think it's over here. Say, I'm glad that's over. That's what, your third? All right, only one left to go. I'll meet you there.
You're ready to get going. Jazargo is ready for more adventure.
Well, what news? Is Elaine? Thank you. That bastard got exactly what he deserved. And I heard about Nilsine. You have more than fulfilled your part of the bargain. Please, take this. As payment, and a symbol of my affection. I'll never forget you.
you're back. So, how went your first real contract? A bit more exciting than what Nazir's been offering, I'd wager? Oh, very good. Very good indeed. You, my dear, are going to fit in here quite nicely. Now, I need your assistance with a matter of a more... personal nature. It's Cicero. Ever since he arrived, his behavior's been... well, erratic would be an understatement. I do believe he is truly mad. But it's worse than that. He's taken to locking himself in the Nightmother's chamber and talking to someone in hushed but frantic tones. Who is he speaking with? What are they planning? I fear treachery. So you understand my fear. If Cicero's planning something and conspiring with one of our own, it would be disastrous. Dear brother, I need you to steal into that chamber and eavesdrop on their meeting. It'll be no use clinging to the shadows. They'll see you for sure. No, you need a hiding place. Somewhere they'd never think to look. Like, inside the Nightmother's coffin. They'll never think to check it. Who in their right mind would hide inside? Now go, before they meet, and report back to me with whatever you learn. I don't believe so. But I'll be able to instruct you further after you've returned from the chamber. It depends on what you learn. And make haste. You must be in place before Cicero and his ally arrive. They could be planning another meeting any time. Go, quickly. Hide in the coffin before Cicero and the traitor meet.
Are we alone?
Yes. Yes! Alone! Sweet solitude! No one will hear us, disturb us. Everything is going according to plan. The others, I've spoken to them, and they're coming around, I know it. The wizard Festus Krex. Perhaps even the Argonian and the Unchild. What about you? Have you spoken to anyone? No? No, of course not. I do the talking, the stalking, the seeing, and the saying. And what do you do? Nothing! Not that I'm angry. No, never. Cicero understands. Cicero always understands. And obeys. You will talk when you're ready, won't you? Won't you? Sweet night, Mother.
Poor Cicero. Dear Cicero. Such a humble servant. But he will never hear my voice. For he is not the listener.
Oh, but how can I defend you? How can I exert your will if you will not speak to anyone?
Oh, but I will speak. I will speak to you, for you are the one. Yes, you. You who shares my iron tomb, who warms my ancient bones. I give you this task. Journey to Wallen Road. Speak with Armand Mortier.
Poor Cicero has failed you. Poor Cicero is sorry, sweet mother. I've tried so very hard, but I just can't find the listener.
Tell Cicero the time has come. Tell him the words he has been waiting for all these years. Darkness rises when silence dies.
What? What treachery? Defiler! Debaser and defiler! You have violated the sanctity of the Night Mother's coffin! Explain yourself! Speak, worm! She spoke to you? More treachery. More trickery and deceit! You lie! The Night Mother speaks only to the listener! And there is no listener! She said that. She said those words. To you. Darkness rises when silence dies. But those are the words. The binding words. Written in the keeping tomes. A signal so I would know. Mother's only way of talking to sweet Cicero. Then it's true. She's back. Our Lady is back. She has chosen a listener. She has chosen you. All hail the listener.
By Sithis, this ends now. Back away, fool. Whatever you've been planning is over.
Are you all right? I heard the commotion. Who was Cicero talking to? Where's the accomplice? Reveal yourself, traitor!
I spoke only to the Night Mother! I spoke to the Night Mother, but she didn't speak to me! Oh, no! She spoke only to him! To the listener!
What? The listener? What are you going on about? What is this lunacy?
It's true! It's true! The Night Mother has spoken! The silence has been broken! The listener has been chosen!
When I heard Cicero screaming, I knew you'd been discovered. I feared the worst. Are you all right? Then what in Sithis' name is going on? Cicero spoke to the Night Mother, but she spoke to you. Is this just more of the fool's rambling?
What?
So Cicero wasn't talking to anyone else. Just the Night Mother's body? And the Night Mother, who, according to everything we know, will only speak to the person chosen as listener, just spoke. Right now. To you? By Sithis. And? What did she say? Amand Motier? I have no idea who that is. But Valenrud, that I have heard of. And I know where it is. No. No! Listen, I don't know what's going on here, but you take your orders from me. Are we clear on that? The Night Mother may have spoken to you, but I am still the leader of this family. I will not have my authority so easily dismissed. I need time to think about all this. Go see Nazir. Do some work for him. I'll find you when I'm ready to discuss the matter further. This is all just too much too fast. Go get some work from Nazir. I need time to think. This is all just too much too fast. Go get some work from Nazir. I need time to think.
Quite a boon, looking like a child. No one ever suspects a thing. My targets make the mistake of not perceiving me as a threat. Last mistake they ever make.
Don't take offense to the nicknames, Morsel. I'm a werewolf.
Brother.
Hard not to think of you as a snack.
Well then, your timing couldn't be better. As it turns out, I've got two new contracts. One rather easy assignment, and another that should prove quite a challenge. Your first target is an orc bard named Lurbuk. The other is a vampire by the name of Hearn. Happy hunting. He is, by all accounts, the worst bard in all of Skyrim. Apparently, so many people sought his death, Astrid had to hold a lottery to determine the client. He's a vampire, and has blended into human society for years. He's never far from his female companion, Hurt, also a vampire. The contract is for the male, Hearn. But you'll probably have to contend with a female, too. So for Sithis' sake, watch yourself. Good luck, and try not to get yourself killed. You reek of death, my friend. I salute you. Brother?